Hi, everybody.
Is that better?
Yeah.
Okay. This is great. It's good to have everybody here. Welcome.
Don't take any film now.
I'll give you the signal. I'm so happy to see everybody. Many of you were at the tea, which I think for those of you who were there, really enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun. And I'm so happy to see you back. And I'd also like to welcome not only our long-term and members who have been with us a while, but we have a new member. Actually, we have 5 new members just in the last few months, which is really exciting. And one of them is with us today, Carol Ford. And Carol was brought to the club by Georgia, so thank you, Georgia. And Dolores, excellent. And as a matter of fact, of the 5, and actually it's 6 new members. And of the 6 new members we've gotten, one was a returning member, and 3 of them were referrals, 2 of them from Ann Lundeen as well, and 2 of them from the newspaper. And as you know, this year we've really had a campaign, we've had a membership campaign to try to increase our numbers. And I've asked everyone to please, you know, when you meet these wonderful ladies out and about, you know, let them know about our club and how great we are and how much fun they would have joining us. So, you know, please keep that up. And I also, although Nancy Russo isn't here with us today, I'd like to commend her because she's been really sending an awful lot of stuff to the media in our city of Weston. I don't know if you get a chance to look at it, but we've been getting some wonderful coverage on the club. As a matter of fact, this month's issue has 3 different mentions of the club, so that's great coverage. I just had a call the other day as a result of one of those entries. A lady called me to ask about Weston Friends, and she said, you know, I'm new to Weston, I've been trying to find some kind of newcomers club and couldn't find anything anywhere, and then I happened to look at the magazine and saw this, our Weston Friends Club, and she said, oh, thank goodness. Called me, I told her about the club, and I believe she will also sign up. She was really excited. So, anyway, welcome to our membership meeting. I do apologize for the fact that we weren't able to have it in April, and I think most of you know we ran into a problem. There was some damage here in the room in the library, so we were forced to postpone it, but I'm glad you all could make it today. We are going to have the installation of officers after lunch, so no worries, we're going to do lunch first. and then we'll do the installation, and then I hope everybody got their raffle tickets. Everybody get a raffle ticket, because we're going to have a little raffle. We'll be raffling off our beautiful decorations. Who are courtesy of our decorating committee, Betsy Zima and Diana Whitfield, and also sister Judy Good. So, and since we are giving thanks, let me now thank Jacqueline. Where's Jacqueline? Jacqueline, who arranged our luncheon for us. Thank you so much, Jacqueline. Thank you for all the details and all the headaches, but hopefully you all will agree, and Jacqueline will agree, that it was worth it. And Nancy, although she's not with us today, Nancy Russo, she's out. As a matter of fact, I got an email from her, and I believe she's in London now?
Dublin.
Pardon?
Dublin.
Dublin. Yes, that's right. So Nancy, I wanted to thank her because she had made arrangements for the catering. So, That's it for me for now. Enjoy lunch, and then we'll get back together again for the installation. Thank you.
Sign up sheets, and we're going to meet on the third Monday of each month, and it's going to be in the afternoon. Becky's group meets in the morning, and we have a sign-up list for substitutes as well as for regular members. Regular members will be asked to host the bunco once a month. And so if we have 12 meetings, that means that you only have to do it once a year. So it shouldn't be too taxing on any of us. And we have such a good time, and we just hope that everybody gets to participate in something. So it's just another one of the wonderful things that Weston Friends offers. And so if you're interested, come see me and we'll sign up. We do plan to meet this month, but you're really supposed to have 12, and we have 6 at this point. So if you don't hear from me, that means that I didn't get the group up, but maybe we'll start again in the fall. I know that a lot of people have a lot of different activities in the summer months, and maybe the fall might be a better time to try. But at any rate, I did want to offer the opportunity. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
As chairman of the nominating committee, it was my privilege to gather the group together, and we are very fortunate that our present officers are willing to serve another term. And so at this time, I would like to call them up individually and for our installation. President Claire Giorgiello. She just sat down, so I'm going to get her up. Vice President of Programs, Jacqueline Stewart. Vice President of Communications, of course, Nancy Russo isn't with us, but we don't want to feel too sorry for her. She's on a cruise. membership, Vice President of Membership, Jeannie Good. Treasurer, Francis Yesbeck. And Secretary, Harriet Brief. And again, we would like to thank all these officers for being willing to serve once more. And now I would...
but we just ate.
We're waiting, the camera's not pointing.
No. You never say that to me.
President, please accept the perfect rose.
Vice President Membership, Jacqueline Stewart, Vice President Programs, Nancy Russo, Vice President of Communications. Your support to the President is likened to the stem of the rose. Without a strong stem, the rose will become limp and fall. Judy, your dedication and diligence, keeping track of the members' dues and producing the informative newsletter each month is necessary to keep members informed and happenings in the club, of happenings in the club. Your acceptance of the yellow rose will signify your commitment to this office. Jacqueline, creating outings, cocktail parties, and social events leads to camaraderie among the members. Without your planning and inventive ideas, the club would lose its purpose. Your acceptance of the yellow rose will signify your commitment to this office. Nancy is not here, but all the articles and pictures in the various newspapers and magazines are a direct result of Nancy's efforts. And we were told how many places it's been in it this month, and we thank Nancy for that. Frances Yesvik, Treasurer. Your office may be likened to the thorns of the rose. There is a reason for the thorns. Their purpose is to protect the rose. The thorns guard against the elements that would detract from its perfect growth. As they protect the rose, you protect the club's funds. Your truthfulness and honesty are impressive attributes. Your acceptance of the yellow rose will signify your continued commitment to your responsibilities. Harriet Green, Secretary. Your reports are a permanent record for the club, and your alertness and conscientious organizational skills are apparent. As secretary, you are like the leaves on the rose stem. The leaves indicate a strong and healthy plant. Without healthy leaves, the rose would not attain its desirable color or live as long. Acceptance of the yellow rose will signify your continued responsibilities to this office. Like all parts of the rose are needed to produce a perfect rose, so too must the board members work together to produce a thriving club. As your installing officer, I declare these officers duly installed. Members, these are your offices. It is your duty to support and assist them in every way. Do you accept your responsibility towards your offices? Please signify that I do.
I do.
Where are you? Okay, that's it. Thank you, Dolores. Beautiful. And thank you, Board. I don't want to get weepy here, but this past year as board president has been so much fun for me, and it's been such a pleasure for me personally, not only working with this fabulous board, and I do keep threatening them that I will not serve if they don't continue to serve. So, but I've really enjoyed the past year. I've enjoyed trying to find new ways to make the club a richer experience for you and make it as much fun as it can be and give everybody the opportunity to make new friends and have fun doing that. So I'm really honored to have the opportunity to serve again this year, and frankly look forward to finding new and even more fun activities. I know that Georgia talked while I had stepped out for a few minutes about forming a new bunco group, and I will ask you if you think of other activities and other fun games, outings, please let us know. Let the board know, let me know, you know how to get a hold of me, because any great ideas that you come up with just help everybody and make the club a richer and more fun organization. And don't forget, we're looking for members, so don't keep the club a secret. It's a wonderful, as you well know, it's a wonderful organization, and we need to really get the word out to everybody. So with that, we have one more fun thing, and that is our raffle. And and by the way, shame on me, although she is not officially an elected officer of the board, she's an important member of the board and a terrific support to me personally and the board as our advisor, and that's Nancy Dunlop. So, Jacqueline, how are we going to handle this? I'm gonna pull the number.
Explain what it's for.
Yeah. Oh, it's for the table centerpieces, the whole thing.
So, well, as your number is called, and all the centerpieces, well, so will people just come in to any table, random table, or to their own table? Okay. Okay, so we're going to pick eight times, and if you're picked at your table, please, everything that is part of the centerpiece is yours to keep.
We have bags?
We have bags.
Excellent. Little gift bags. Once more, we spare no expense. All right, first number, 185366. Great. glue sticks together. Who put the super glue in here? 185-394.
That's me, but I'm not taking it.
Oh, okay.
You've seen enough of this.
All right.
Yes.
185-363.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, I think the fix is in.
Okay. Next number, 185-395.
Georgia, need to pick one. There's one here, Georgia.
There's one here, Georgia. No,
thank you.
Wait, do we have one left?
Yes.
There's one left.
Two more.
Two.
One more now.
One more now. Okay. Excellent. All right. The last number, 185-384. Woo!
You got an extra bonus, a couple of sandwiches in there.
Oh, really? We're right at you. Thank you. Here, should we?
No, pick up the whole thing. There we go.
All right.
Yeah.
Can we
do
it?
Ideas coming. And also, Jacqueline, what is our next activity? I'm kind of losing track. Haven't been away.
Good question.
Pardon?
You've got a chip.
Good question. Chip, read the newsletter.
What? Break it. Oh, that's chip.
Yeah, I saw the cancellation, which is on the sky. We're going to have brunch.
We are going to plan a member brunch during the summer months. Jacqueline had graciously offered her home, and she had done that as well last year. And some of you who attended, we had such a good time. That would be potluck. So we haven't set a date yet. So keep looking at your newsletter. Chick Flicks next week, Great Gatsby. Chick Flicks is not an official activity of Weston Friends, but I do schedule them as often as I can and invite anyone and everyone to join us, including the guys. And believe it or not, a long, long time ago, we did have a husband join us. So I do want to thank Herb, who's become our videographer and photographer and does such a spectacular job. We really thank you. Really thank you for that. And any comments, questions, suggestions, ideas, complaints?
No.
To yourself? We have plastic containers. If anybody would like to take some of the wonderful wraps sandwiches home, they're fabulous, but you have quite a few left over. So if you'd like to take some, please feel free to help yourself. Thank you. Thank you all. Have a great rest of the day. And a great summer, and happy Mother's Day.